I'm also an optimist. I always believe that the role of government is to help us.
Pleasure. Participating in school events with my kids. I have three kids, two who are now in college, graduating from Cambridge Region Latin High School. I have another daughter in private school, and over the years I've been a board member on CYS, which is Cambridge Youth Soccer. What qualifies me to be a city council member is bringing a background of all different people together. I've been in so many different organizations. I've built computer labs at 808, as well as taught computers in 1010 Memorial Drive. What is needed is where we are now and where we're gonna go is the most important factor we're dealing with right now in Cambridge. And what we're gonna need as city councilors are people with forward thinking and willing to step beyond where we are now to deal with some of the issues. My ability to bring people together and focus on what needs to be done to get to where we need to go. The basic issue of housing is very important. People fall all over the map in terms of the housing versus the open space issue. Quality of life is clearly important to people. In area four, rats. So that's down to the basic issue. That's a very important issue to people. And safety is an important issue. Overall, it's a changing city that we're in. And how we manage, and that's starting at the top from public officials, city councils, how we manage that change with people, it's going to determine how the issues change throughout the time. And depending on where we are in time, what the issues are going to be. Education is right up at the top for everybody, regardless of whether you have kids or not. Your schools reflect your property values. So, we're all having so many problems. Where are you going to end up at the end of the day in terms of what are the real benefits to Cambridge residents? As Ms. Simmons pointed out, you're talking 1 or 2 bedroom units. That to me suggests a situation that may be transient because young people come in, they buy the units, they marry, they want to start families, they move out. So therefore you, in terms of a friendly family city, I'm not convinced yet that we will see the benefits out of North Point. I hope we see the benefits out of North Point. It will benefit some. Will it benefit the city entirely? I'm not sure. Last I heard, it was still tied up in court, and part of it was being forced. The developers were being forced to sell to another developer because they couldn't agree on things. So I always wonder, if you start off with so many problems in the beginning, where are you going to end up and who are you going to bring into the process to help you straighten it out? Because if the residents aren't, the people that are going to be impacted by it aren't involved in it, I'm not convinced. Oh, I'm sorry. So when you go to get money, the first thing they ask you for is where's your business plan? You know, when we talk about our schools, we want to know when we hire a superintendent, what is your plan? Where are you going to take us in the next 5 or 10 years? So it's almost unconscionable that we don't have a plan. And the plan has to be flexible. It has to have some room to grow, to change, to include, you know, whatever we need to adjust to. But if you have a family, you have a plan, you know. You have plans for your kids, you have plans for futures. So I think that has to be almost mandatory of the city council to come up with some sort of plan to be working off of, because it's a guiding tool, it's a compass. You know, we have to have some idea where you're going. And you might alter the method that you use to get there, but you gotta have an idea of where you're going, because otherwise, who's running your city? And people talking to kids. Because once you start to engage kids in conversation, a lot of what is going on will not go on in terms of a lot of the crime. Because if people know people, and I know this kid here, and I always see him there, and instead of running away from him, saying, hey, how you doing today? You know, as we read the event last night, somebody said, did you ask the kid, did he go to school today? What did you do today? Because once you start to engage people, and then you start to, first of all, let them know that you're interested in them, and you start to change some of their behaviors. And I think that's an important part of what we're seeing in Cambridge. I understand people's concerns around some of the crime that's going on in Cambridge. Somebody said last night, you know, we're going to be like Boston. We're not like Boston. There's 50 murders in Boston. 50 people have died. That's not happening here. So we got to continue to talk to people and community police. Any job interview, what I hope happens, and I've sat on many job interviews on both ends of hiring people and looking to be hired. And what I hope happens is that you have the opportunity to look over time at our records to see what we have done and what we both promised to do and judge it as we go along. I hope to bring to the City Council a new energy. I hope to bring dedication and hard work. I hope to listen 20 years as a counselor, being able to learn what people, being able to listen to what people want and what people need, and being able to represent their views in terms of what they need. When we get hired, we work for the entire city. Okay, thank you very much. So go to LarryMoore.org and you will get a clear picture of me and be able to make your decision about my job as your city councilor. Thank you very much.